know the orchestra has been itching to play, waiting for a good 45 minutes, and we have, like I said, the second half here is the Old World, or the European continent, so featuring the string ensemble. We started off with the Al Noni and the Beethoven piece, and now we're going to continue to England. Ray Vaughan Williams, his three English folk songs. This is actually originally for band, and it was, I don't know why, but his good friend Gordon Jacob transcribed it for orchestra. Not that Vaughan Williams couldn't do it himself, but this is the version that most orchestras play, is the three folk songs, English folk songs. Thank you.
Thank you.
The next three pieces that we're going to bring in are French sequence, so crossing the English Channel over to the shores of Normandy. And we're going to go chronologically, so actually it's going to be Fauré first, so that we're going to hear the Fauré Pavane, and then the Erik Satie Jeu Normandy. So Fauré Pavane is actually scored with choir, and last year we were very lucky to collaborate with the choir for the first time. And unfortunately this semester they're quite busy, as are we, and we hope to work with them and get to put on a concert together in the future and maybe feature this piece in its full entirety. So for now is the Fauré Pavane, followed by the Satie Jeu Normandy.
Thank you.
Passatige de Malpetit is actually written for piano. It's probably his most well-known work, and was orchestrated by Claude Debussy, who was then getting popular at the time, and so lent his name to Satie as an orchestrator, and this piece now exists in both forms. You hear it all the time, either on piano or as an orchestra. Somehow Debussy felt, there were actually three of them, and he felt the second one didn't quite lend itself to orchestrate. Didn't sound good for the orchestra, couldn't make it work. So you only hear the first and the third, and then he reversed the order of them. So, but whatever, as you have it, it's just two of them. So here are the Gymnopédies by Erik Satie, as orchestrated by Debussy.
Thank you.
one thing the French are masters of is subtlety. The third piece in our French sequence is by a famous composer, Georges Delerue, who many of you may not know, but he was proclaimed by Le Figaro, the French newspaper, as the Mozart of the cinema. Some of his impressive credits are that he actually scored for over 300 films. Imagine that, 300 films. How many? What's your favorite hobby? If it's like it was golf, if you played 300 golf games in your life, he scored over 300 films. Some of them in Hollywood you may even know, such as Platoon, Biloxi Blues, or just come to mind, and then find this one, Rich and Famous, starring Candice Bergen and Jack Nicholson. Back in the 1980s. So he actually, not for this film, but has won Academy Awards. And we are gracious to have Madame Delerue, his wife, here tonight with us. Colette, where are you? Can you stand up, please? Madame Delerue, unfortunately, passed away in 1980s. And she has graciously granted us permission to play her husband's work here. And if the music is any indication of what your husband was like, he must have been a wonderful man. And we are glad to know him through his music. So thank you very much for allowing us to play.
Thank you.
Hans Trevino, and he's at USC. So USC is still keeping up with the good tradition and all of the guests. Our last number is we now journey further south to the Mediterranean. So with Rossini, the overture to his opera Semiramide. It was actually his last of the Italian sequence. From this, there were four more others, but they were basically French librettos. William Tell, of course, being probably the most famous. But Rossini was a happy guy. He supposedly only cried twice in his life. Once is when he heard Paganini play viola. He was so touched and moved to tears. And the other time, because he loved to eat, on a picnic out by the creek, the turkey was in the basket and fell out and rolled into the stream. Only two known instances of him crying. So. The opera, needless to say, composers write the overture as the last bit, and they're lucky to even throw in a few tunes from the opera itself. And Semiramide does have some, but it's a wonderful piece, and the reason I chose it is because we have four fabulous forms that are here at Fulton College that I wanted to feature, and you'll see in the introduction that it features them very prominently. So our last number is the Rossini Semiramide Overture. And once again, I'd like to thank you, everyone, for coming out and supporting us. And we hope to see you again next year.
Thank you.